What are we looking at? What's positive climate? Is it a domain or a dimension?
Dimension.
What is an indicator? Let's see if you...
Like relationship, positive, like that.
Perfect. So positive climate is a dimension. Indicator is relationship, positive affect, positive communication, and respect. So think of it this way. These are the things that indicate to the scorer that there is a positive climate, okay? And then what are the things that we look for under each indicator? Remember what those are called? Behavioral markers, okay? So then under each of these are behavioral markers. So what's a behavioral marker for positive affect? Smiling, laughter, and enthusiasm. We know affect, or now you do, affect is our face. If you have a positive affect, it's what your face looks like. If I say someone had a very negative affect, it means they were frowning or flinching or whatever it might be. It's what affect is what their face looks like. So positive affect is smiling, laughing. You can tell when someone's positive by their face. They don't have to say anything. So it's nonverbal cues. What's a behavioral marker underneath respect?
Eye contact.
Perfect. So what under respect do you need to be aware of the cultural limitations of that?
Eye contact.
And class is fully aware of this. This is why there's multiple behavioral markers. And when we talk about scoring in just a second, you'll need to understand that this is something that needs to be taken through the filter of what is culturally appropriate for that room. All right, so what is the domain?
Emotional.
Emotional. It's not even up there. Look how smart you are. You remembered. All right, so it's emotional support. So positive climate is the dimension. Indicators, again, right there. I'm not going to go over that because you've done it. All right, what's the dimension? Perfect. What's the behavioral markers?
Yeah, we need physical control.
Punitive control, sarcasm, and severe negativity. Okay? So remember, this is the one where we want to have a lower score. And if you look over here, this is what the rater is going to be rating. Okay? So if there's high negative affect, the classroom is characterized by consistent irritability, anger, or other negative affect by teacher and or peers. So in every other dimension, we want to be on the high range. On the negative climate, we want to be on the low range, right? We want to have low negative climate. Why do you think they measure negative climate? Why wouldn't it just be good enough to measure positive climate? Yep, and we need to know that these affect the children. And also, if we get kind of mid-range on the positive climate, if we are very high on negative climate, just because we're not too bad on positive, will a negative climate adversely affect the child?
Yes.
So this is something that needs to be measured. So what are the indicators? Oops. What are the behavioral markers? How's that? What are the behavioral markers? Perfect. These are the behaviors that are underneath the indicators. Starting to get the pattern? Good. What is the domain? Emotional support. Good. Okay. So negative climate, one of the things that we're tempted to do in negative climate, if you become a scorer, is that we judge based on how much we like the teacher, okay? So this is where, and this is why, we have this extensive training so that you have to mark it in a certain way. But negative climate is something we will be most tempted, if you become a scorer, to be subjective about, okay? That's why we have all of those behavioral indicators, because we might just not like how the teacher interacts with the child, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's a negative climate. So that's something that we do need to be cognizant and to think about. All right. What's the dimension?
Teacher sensitivity.
What are the indicators under teacher sensitivity? Perfect. What is the next? What is, let's see, problem resolution. What is that called? What is this? Is it a dimension?
Behavioral
marker, right? Is this starting to become more clear? Wait till we talk about scoring. Okay? So then remember, each of these are rated. So you have your domain, your dimension, and then each indicator is rated based on the behavioral markers that are seen. Okay, is the picture becoming a little fuzzy at least? It'll become a little bit clearer. So what's the domain?
Emotional
support. Good. Okay. Dimension, regard for student perspectives is a?
Dimension.
Whoops. Oh, I guess I don't have animations. Oh, that's right. I stopped animating so that you guys, because I knew you got it, right? Say yes. We don't need more pointers. So captures the degree to which teachers' interactions and students' classroom activities place an emphasis on student interests, motivation, and points of view. Really look at how detailed this tool is. This is just measuring the interaction, so it's covering every facet. I mean, this is an entire measurement of how well the teacher respects what the students have to say, their likes, their wants, their perspectives. That's huge. There's no other tool that does that. Okay? And so one of the things that the class has come under fire about is because, first of all, it's so expensive, and second of all, it's so difficult to be trained in it. But I really want you to think critically about the fact that there are so many different measurements. Do you see now how you can't just pick up this booklet and go and say, I can measure someone on this? It's huge. Okay? What's an indicator under this dimension? Flexibility, support of autonomy, student expression, restriction of movement. Okay? So if we're looking at a pre-K classroom and children are belted in, you know, as they sit at the table, is that a restriction of movement? And I've seen it in pre-K classrooms because 2.5-year-olds and 3-year-olds, do they still get out of their seat a lot? Yes. What is a behavioral marker underneath student expression? Elicits ideas and perspectives. Good. All right. So what is the next domain? So we've talked about emotional support, right? That's one domain. What's this domain?
Classroom
organization. And how many dimensions are underneath that domain? Three. Good. See how smart you are. Okay, what is a dimension? Say behavioral management. Oh yeah, that's right. Don't let me keep doing that. I forget I'm not animating for you guys. Where is a behavioral marker? Give me one behavioral marker.
Rarely
I'm switching it up. What's a behavioral marker?
It's rarely
reactive is one. What's another one? Any of these, right? You could just mumble them. Blah, blah, blah. There, good. You did a behavioral marker. So remember, these are behavioral marker. What's an indicator?
Student behavior.
Right here, right? These are indicators. Good. The behavior management, dimension, productivity. What's the dimension?
Productivity.
I can say it, but you guys don't always repeat it back correctly. So you giggle, but yet I know you. All right. So what is productivity? How do you measure productivity? Considers how well the teacher manages instructional time and routines and provides activities for students so that they have the opportunity to be involved in productivity. It's not how well the teacher engages the students. Remember, that is something else that is being measured. It's how the teacher helps the students stay on task. That's a huge thing to measure. This is classroom management, okay? If a teacher yells across the room and says, "Get back to your drawing," is that increasing productivity? No, we might think it does because it might immediately make them turn, but it doesn't make them listen to us. So learning isn't measured. Again, it's not a cognitive thing. We're not saying how well they learn their ABCs or 1, 2, 3s. It's how well the teacher supports the children staying on task. Isn't that a really neat thing to try and measure? It's difficult. Can you imagine trying to measure that? Again, this is why there's such extensive training. As a teacher would this be very valuable feedback. If you've noticed during work time for the 2 hours, it just seems like everything dissolves into chaos, would it be great to be evaluated and say, well, this is why you're failing. You're not supporting the children to be productive. And again, a great teacher says, oh, good, now I know exactly what I need to do. And says, I do fine. It's just these kids have behavioral problems. Their parents would just step up, it wouldn't be an issue. That's simply not true. It's the teacher's responsibility. It's very difficult sometimes to get the results of these evaluations because they're very specific. So it will catch every single little thing. And again, just like the Eckers, just because one score is low doesn't mean you're a horrible teacher. No. It means there are things you can improve on. Can every single teacher improve?
Yes.
I'm phenomenal, and I can improve. Say, no, you can't, because I haven't graded you yet. Of course. But yes, every teacher can improve.